come from the mountains and faraway lands. Young boys and young girls with short attention spans. Have you not gossiped? Have you not heard of Superio Magnific who transformed the world? But none of this was greater than the love he would hold for his lady fiancée, the flame for his soul. Every canvas he painted, every portrait he drew, took him high as the hills of Brabigamazoo. But to make all this, he must leave his home, away from her kisses and sweet honey tones, with promises of riches and silvers and golds, while his lady fiancée was left all alone. On his way, so excited about the gig of his life, he said, "Why don't I marry Fiancee and make her my wife?" He never could have guessed what lay behind the door was his beautiful Fiancee, dead on the floor. His paintings were everywhere, torn and in shreds. Brushes and pencils by her head where she bled. He called for the ambulance. He screamed for their help. How many police you know come when you yell? Yes, I tell you. Sadly, I say, all that he made could not keep her from graves. He looked at her face. He mourned and he wished, if I was here with my pistol, could I have stopped all of this? But there was nothing left more. No choice was he able just to stare at her pale face and the lace that he gave her. And even more badly, a letter that read, "The writing of Fiancee," and here's what it said.
"I love you, Superior. Your talent is great. One day, what a popular artist you'll make. I glow in your company. Your words make me laugh, but you're always away, and it all makes me sad. Our times in the park, and gazes in the dark, are but windows in the tower of my broken up heart."
"Please don't be hurt. When you return, I'll be gone. I hope you'll be famous and one day get on. Be strong, but your art and our love cannot mix. But maybe one day I hope this is something we'll fix."
He looked at the letter. He wailed and he wept. The guilt that he felt almost put him to death. My art, my stupid, stupid art made me useless and misunderstood from the stupid, useless start.
"That's the last of my things. I'll zip up then leave, early in the day before he get a chance to see."
"Stop right there. No, not that I care. But your artist, does he live here? If not there, then where?"
"No, no, he does not stay here. So go, go."
"Well, he owns, owns, and I'll cancel shows and take away homes and take away even his underclothes."
"Leave this room now, or you'll see a spark. I'll stab this butcher knife right through your heart. I'll stab
you. Go, go.